I do. Accept my love, or I'll perish on the spot. You know not what you say. Listen. On a tree by a river, a little tomtit, sitting willow, tit, willow, tit, willow. And I said to him, Dickie, why do you sit, singing willow, tit, willow, tit, willow? Is it weakness of intellect, Betty, I cried, or a rather tough worm in your little inside, with a shake of his poor little head he replied. Oh, willow, tit, willow, tit, willow. He slept at his chest as he sat on the bough, singing willow, tit, willow, tit, willow. And a cold perspiration bestained his brow, oh, willow, tit, willow, tit, willow. He sat and he sat, and a cradle he gave, then he threw himself into the billowy wave, and an echo arose from a suicide's grave. Oh, willow, tit, willow, tit, willow. Now I feel just as sure as I'm sure that my name is it willow, tit, willow, tit, willow. That was blighted affection that made him exclaim, oh, willow, tit, willow, tit, willow. And if you remain callous and obdurate, I shall perish as he did, and you will know why. Though I probably shall not exclaim as I die, oh, willow, tit, willow.
Und die Gäste schwüren zu, schwüren zu. Impfen bin ich. lies heavy on my chest and weaves itself into my midnight slumbers. When you're lying awake with a dismal headache and repose is tabooed by anxiety, I conceive we may use any language you choose to indulge without impropriety. For your brain is on fire, the bedclothes conspire of usual slumber to plunge you. First your count of pain goes, then uncovers your toes, and your sheet slips demurely from under you. Then the blanketing tickles, you feel like mixed pickles, so terribly sharp is the pricking. And your heart and your grass, you tumble and toss to, there's nothing twixt you and the ticking. Then the bedclothes are gripped to the ground in a heap, and you pick them all up in a tangle. Next your pillow resigns and politely declines to remain at its usual angle. Well, you get some repose in the form of a doze with hot eyeballs and head of an aching. But your slumbering teens are such horrible dreams that you'd very much better be waking. For you dream you're crossing the channel and tossing about in a steamer from Harwich, which is something between a large bathing machine and a very small second-class carriage. And you're giving a treat, penny icicle bit, to a party of friends and relations. They're a ravenous horde and they all came on board at some 12 of Kensington stations. And bound on that journey you find your attorney who started that morning from Devon. He's a bit undersized and you don't feel surprised when he tells you he's only 11. When you're driving like mad with a sink in the land, by the ship's now a four-wheeler. And you're playing around games and he calls you bad names and you tell him that time's been a dealer. But this you can't stand, you draw up your hand and you find you're as cold as an icicle. And your shirt and your socks and that silk and your trunks cross and soles break plain on a bicycle. And he and the crew are in bicycles too, which they've somehow or other invested in. And he's telling the tars or the particulars of a company he's interested in. It's a scheme of devices to get at low prices on goods from off fixtures to cables, which tickle the sailors by treating retainers as though they were all vegetables. You get a good spadesman to plant a small tradesman, first take off his boots with the boot tree, and his legs will take root, and his fingers will shoot, and the blossom will bud like a fruit tree. From the grain grocery tree you get grapes and green pea, cauliflower, pineapple, and cranberries. While the pastry will crunch, teddy brandy will grunt, apple puffs and three quarters and banberries. The shares are a penny and ever so many are taken by Rothschild and Baring. And just as a few are allotted to you, you're away from the shadow is wearing. You're a regular wreck with a crick in your neck and a one-use law for your hands on the floor. And your needles and pins from your soles to your shins. And your fletches are crimped for your legs asleep. And you've clamped on your toes and apply your nose. It's a flap on your lug and a feverish tongue. And if this is intense in a general sense, darkness has passed in its daylight at last, and the night has been long, ditto, ditto, my song. And the great goodness there, both of them,
I looked and I thought to myself,
I thought as I thanked all the stars in the
only reckoned a true philanthropist. It is my very humane endeavor to make to some extent each evil liver a running river of harmless merriment. My optical sublime I shall achieve in time to let the punishment fit the crime, the punishment fit the crime, and make his prisoner bent on wing and represent a source of innocent merriment, of innocent merriment. Sinners would chatter and bleat and bore. I sent his servants from mystical German to preach from 10 till 4. The amateur tenor whose vocal villainies all desire to shirk shall during our powers exhibit his powers to sing for his dinner at work. The lady who dyes a chemical yellow or stains her grey her puce or pinches her figure is painted with vigour. With no hope of letting it loose, the idiot who on a railway carriage scribbles on window panes, we only suffer to ride on a buffer in a parliamentary train. My optical sublime I shall achieve in time to let the punishment fit the crime, the punishment fit the crime, and make each prisoner bent on willingly represent a source of innocent merriment, of innocent merriment. The advertising quack who wearies with tales of countless cures, his team by vernacular shall all be extracted by terrified amateurs. The musical singer attends a series of masses and fugues and orps, by Bach interwoven with Brahms and Beethoven, its classical Sunday pops. The billiard sharp, whom anyone catches, his doom's extremely hard. He's made to dwell in a dungeon, a cell, on a spot that's always barred. And there he plays extravagant matches in fitless finger stars, on a cloth untrue, with a twisted cue. And elliptical billiard balls. Balls. My optical sublime I shall achieve in time to let the punishment fit the crime, the punishment fit the crime, and make his prisoner burn.
Thank you. feet I threw, I was a lovesick boy. No term seems too extravagant upon you to employ. I used to mope and sigh and pant, just like a lovesick boy. Tink-a-tank, 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 tink-a-tank. I used to mope and sigh and pant, just like a lovesick boy. But joy incessant palls the sense, and love unchanged will cloy. And she became a bore intense unto a lovesick boy. With fitful glimmer burnt my flame, and I grew cold and coy. At last one morning I became another's lovesick boy. Tick-a-tank, 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 tick-a-tank. At last one morning I became another's lovesick boy.
Oh! Affiderella mi birra un tedesco.
commerescono l'andese l'urco. La mia bottiglia, la tua vita, un turco, no! Mia moglie se stessa, olai da sorte, quella brutta parola in cor mi torna, lei torna, due padron le fusa torte, oh, lei torna, lei torna! Le accoppio, 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 le accoppio!